Hello dear student, this is Dr. Sugandha Khangar Wagh, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, expressing the atmosphere and geophysics, that is Unit 6 for B.Sc. second year semester 3. This is my third lecture. Now these are the outlines, that is the structure of earth, introductory part of structure of earth, internal structure of earth. Now see here, the structure of earth. Now the earth is given here, the structure of earth is given here. See, for outer part of the earth is called as crust. Then the core, that is the outer core, inner core and mantle also. We will discuss whole in details in next slide. Now this is the introductory part. The interior of earth becomes hotter with depth. Direct observations about the internal structure of earth is not possible. So here, with present scientific methods, below the earth surface we can hardly penetrate up to the few kilometer. Now see here, the average radius of earth is taken as 6371 kilometer. From this we cannot get complete information about internal structure of the earth. So the information about internal structure of earth is based on indirect methods. The seismic waves, the waves which are generated from the earthquake or the other vibrations of the earth, are called as seismic waves, and the seismic waves generated at the time of earthquake are recorded on the surface of the earth is a major source for finding the information about the internal structure of the earth. Now see this point can be used to fill in the blanks. You know that in your question paper pattern there is first question, that is fill in the blanks. So that point, that is the seismic waves generated at the time of earthquake are recorded on the surface of the earth, is a major source for finding the information about the internal structure of earth, that is most important. So concentrate on this point. The seismic waves gets reflected and refracted from the viscous depends on the waves traveling through the earth. If we try to record the velocity of the seismic waves on the opposite ends of the earth, then if there is no change in the velocity of seismic wave, indicate the earth has uniform structure from the surface to the center. See this point, concentrate toward this point. If we record the velocity of the seismic waves on the earth at the end of the earth, and if the velocity is constant, then we can say that, or it is the indication of earth has uniform structure from the surface to the center. But the observed fact tells us that there is a major change in velocity of these seismic waves, known as seismic discontinuity. This indicates that there is a change in internal material of earth after a particular depth. Really, what happened? See, it is indicates in this point, the earth do not have uniform velocity. That is, if we measure the velocity of the earth at one end, it may be discontinuous. That is, it may be vary. It is not constant. And this indicates that there is the change in the internal material of the earth after a particular path. During the process of transformation from a hot gaseous state to the present state of earth, cooling, the heavier material sank down and the lighter material floated up. Due to this, there is the formation of different layers of different densities. See this sentence. During this process, the transformation from a hot gaseous state to the present state of earth, cooling, the heavier material is heavy, that's why it is sank down, and then lighter material floated up, and due to this there is the formation of different layers of different densities. Now come towards the actual internal structure of the earth. See here, the internal structure of the earth is divided into three main categories. One is the crust, the mantle and the core. Now see, this is the structure. This is the earth structure, and that one is the different, means the structure is located in this diagram also. So here crust is the outermost part of the earth. See here, that part of the earth is called as crust, and it range and its width is, or its width is from 0 to 33 kilometer, means its thickness is 33 kilometer, tentatively 33 kilometer, not exactly. Now second one is mantle. See here, that is upper mantle and lower mantle mentioned here, and in this diagram see that one, that is the orange color and yellow color, that is the mantle, and the thickness of this layer is 2900 kilometer. After that, the core is divided into the outer core and inner core. See here, and see in this diagram also, the central part of the earth is called as core. See here that both the parts, both the layers are called as core, and its thickness is nearly 6371 kilometer. It means that the radius of the earth is tentatively 6371 kilometer, and after that there is some part situated, that is the troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. We will study it later on. Now we will see the crust, mantle and the core deeply. See in this slide, the crust is the uppermost layer of earth, as I discussed earlier. The thickness is not constant everywhere, so its thickness in the different areas given below. Under the mountain area, its thickness is 60 to 75 kilometer. Under the continental area, thickness is 30 to 40 kilometer. Continental area means the area covered, large amount of area covered, that is called as the continental area, that is the Asian area and all. And the under the oceanic area, its thickness is 5 to 19 kilometer. The thickness may vary at some places. In an average, the depth of the crust is taken as 33 kilometer, as I discussed earlier in the diagram. You can see the diagram for this again. Below the earth surfaces, the solid part that makes the crust is known as rocks. The crust is made from the different types of rocks. About chemical composition of rocks, that is the crust, analyzed by different observers, it is divided into two types. One is the CL and another one is the SEMA. So see here, we will see the CL and SEMA one by one. See here, CL, which is the uppermost continental crust. This part of the crust is rich in silica and aluminium, so it is called as CL layer. SI indicates silica and AL indicates aluminium. See here, the rocks are granitic in compositions. As you know that the granite rock, it consists of that particle like structure having different colors, so the rocks are granitic in composition. This layer consists of all types of rocks exposed at the earth surface. Now another one part is SEMA. It is the lower continental crust. This part of crust is rich with silica and magnesium, so it is known as the SEMA layer, which indicates the silica, that is in SEMA, SI indicates silica and MA indicates magnesium. The rocks are basaltic in composition, as you heard the name of basalt rock. So the SEMA rocks are basaltic in composition. Further, the SEMA is divided into the outer SEMA and inner SEMA. As per the chemical composition of crust, the rock in the crust contains C, silica, that is SiO2, 50 to 60%. Alumina, that is Al2O3, 12 to 16%. Then ferrous oxide, Fe2O3, that is 7 to 8%. Lime, CaO, 5 to 6%. And other oxides of sodium, magnesium, potassium, titanium, etc., 12%. Now come towards the another part of the earth, that is the mantle. It is the next concentric shell of the earth below the crust. It lies from lower boundary of the crust to a depth of 2900 kilometer. It is believed that the mantle part is in solid state, but the recent studies shows that the upper part of mantle is from 100 to 500 kilometer in plastic state, and the material of the mantle is generally viscous in nature. This region supports the slowly moving tectonic plates which causes the earthquake. This region is a source of much volcanic activity of the earth and contains most of the earth internal energy. Now see here, the region of the source is much volcanic activity. It means that large amount of vibrations created there, and due to this it requires the large amount of earth internal energy. Now chemically, mantle is made up of extremely basic material called as aptly ultra basic. It is very rich in iron and magnesium but poor in silica. In this region, the density of material increases with depth. Now the third part is the core, which is the innermost concentric shell of the earth. It lies below the mantle region. The core boundary begins nearly from the depth 2900 kilometer and it extends up to the center of the earth, that is 6371 kilometer. It is believed that the outer core behaves like liquid and the inner core behaves like a metallic solid. It is also believed that core is mainly made from iron and nickel. The composition of material in core is not uniform throughout the day. The material has very high density at mantle core boundary. So these are the parts of the earth, that is the crust, which is the outer part of the earth. The middle part is mantle, that is the outer mantle and inner mantle, and the innermost part is the core, that is we can say outer core and inner core. And the radius of earth, here we study tentative radius of earth, is 6371 kilometer. After that we will study the earth acts as a planet in next lecture. So you will write down whole theory in your copy and do study hard. And if your friend do not have mobile, share your screen with your mobile and inform to the teacher. Thank you so much.